Good evening, everyone. Today I will be talking about popular drama.
Last.
So it's one of the major cause of trauma is one of the popular emergency reported in trauma centers. So about 1.6 blindness are caused by eye ocular injury, and 19 million cases of monocular blindness is due to ocular trauma. There is no guess male rate is more prone for trauma than female. More common in rural areas and in lower socioeconomic background, illiteracy and conflicts also another common risk factor for ocular trauma. Based on nature of injurious agent, ocular trauma can be classified as mechanical, chemical, radiation injury, thermal injury and electrical injury. So when a patient comes with any ocular trauma, first you have to rule out life-threatening injury, then globe-threatening injuries. You have to examine both the eyes. If imaging is necessary, should be done, and then plan for treatment. So history like mechanism of trauma, blunt force or penetrating injury, or both the forces are involved. Any previous injury and previous ocular surgery history is also important, because even with minor trauma, eye with previous ocular surgery, you can have perforating injury. So then next patient has to be reviewed for any life-threatening condition, which should be treated first. If there is intracranial injury, that should be treated first. Then only once the patient is stabilized, then we have to treat for ocular injury. Then facial examination has to be done for look for any laceration, weakness and numbness. In coming to ocular examination, first vision has to be assessed. Then lids and lacrimal system, look for the orbital rim. If there is any irregular margin, if that indicates possibility of orbital fracture. Even check for ocular motility. Sometimes when there is orbital fracture, muscle can get entrapped, which lead to the decreased ocular motility in that direction. Then coming to mechanical injury, this compromises about 80% of ocular trauma. So it can be various. So in mechanical injury, most commonly encountered will be corneal foreign body. Usually the foreign body size will be about 0.5 millimeter. If left untreated, it can cause rust ring. Second, it can also get infected secondly. Then other can be blunt trauma. Blunt trauma can be due to direct blow by fist, ball or any blunt instruments. Then accident, blunt trauma to eyeball can occur in roadside accidents, injuries by agricultural and industrial machine, and fall of any projecting object. So,
for the blindness.
Sir, it depends upon how much injured and how early they report. That also matters. If they come within 6 hours and not much damage, usually vision can be preserved, sir.
Left injuries in children, often they get hurt with a tennis ball,
yes,
or a cricket ball, or some clear kicking with their hands, etc. How do you really manage this?
So first we will, any patient with blunt injury, we will assess for vision first, sir. Most of the time, vision will be okay, only blunt injury, subconjunctival hemorrhage is the most common. That will resolve on its own within 2 to 3 weeks. Sometimes corneal epithelial defect can also occur. In that case, we usually prescribe lubricant. So assess vision first, then check for pupillary reaction and extraocular movement. If this thing is fine, nothing much blood been affected, sir.
Mostly you would prefer every patient to be seen by a ophthalmologist. Obviously, it's an eye and we can't take any chance.
Yes, sir, because fundus also need to be evaluated, because if macula is not involved, vision may not be affected.
So as a practitioner, we would not be able to see what is inside most of the time. And it would be safe and maybe a good lesson for you to see, refer to your ophthalmologist at some time.
Yes, that will be better, sir.
Patients developing sympathetic ophthalmitis in the normal age?
Very less. Usually it will take years, but for ruling out sympathetic ophthalmitis, usually we have to rule out other inflammatory conditions. Usually it will present like pan uveitis, involvement of all three groups of the liver. So we will rule out. Like treatment will be same as any uveitis only. We will give intense steroids.
Thank you. Now, any case of that, Dr. Manu, I am a person to handle it. Certificate of appreciation to Dr. D. Priya.